Hello, my name is Alkyon and welcome to my channel. In this video I'm going to explore two comics. The first is a Korean comic also known as manhwa, and you know the Japanese ones are called manga and the Chinese comics I think they're called manhua. And the second comic is an indie comic. Before I go on, I will announce that I am in my pajamas and I don't think it matters, but it's cold, so I don't want to dress up for a video. Yeah, maybe I will continue making videos in my pajamas. So, let's begin with the first comic, The Breaker. I had read this a long time ago, years ago, but I really love this comic. But let's begin by reading the summary, which I cannot see. Hold on. The new English teacher, Chan Woo, is not your ordinary teacher. Seon, a victim of constant bullying, unexpectedly witnesses Chan Woo's fighting prowess and begs him to make him his disciple. Chan Woo claims he can teach Seon only if he is truly determined, and Seon must put his life on the line to prove it. It turns out, however, that Chan Woo and his powers are more than meets the eye. Seon makes a grand entrance into the Murim, the hidden world of martial arts, and he is about to be taught by the best there is. So, this is the cover of the first chapter. I really like this comic. I probably ruined the English pronunciation of several words there, but I really like this comic. It's not, you know, I actually read several reviews to see what people thought of it, and many people complained that it is the average usual, you know, comic with someone who gains powers and things like that. But in my opinion, it is not. I actually witnessed, well, okay, first of all, the art is amazing. And it is not like the Japanese comics. Korean comics, personally, I like them more. They are, I don't know, I think Japanese are more slow-paced. Although this story too, it took a while to get into the fighting scenes and things like that. But I don't know, let's say it's a personal taste. Maybe in one video I will make a list of all the reasons why I prefer Korean comics to Japanese ones. Although I began by reading Japanese comics. This is the new teacher and he's amazing. I really like the art. I like the fighting scenes, although there weren't that many, there could have been more. And what I love about this comic is that the protagonist, who is, you know, a victim of bullying, he is very weak and all that stuff, he becomes better, and personality wise, although it takes a while, I did see a development. I read in the reviews many people didn't see a development, but I did, and that's why I recommend this comic, and I have reviewed very highly. I really liked it. It was more than I expected. This is one of the most recent pages. That's really nice. I really love the main character, and I mean the teacher, and the student too. As he progressed, I liked him more and more, and he really exceeded my expectations. I really like this comic. I would really recommend it. I do not believe it is the usual, you know, the comic where someone gains powers, and I don't think it's that usual. I don't think it has this characteristics that this kind of stories usually have. I think it's different. You will have to read it and judge on your own. So let's go to the second comic, which is Ascent. I actually couldn't find the cover for this comic, so I chose a panel of one of the chapters. So let's read the summary. Alright. Ascent is a comedy drama about an isolated hard hat diver who contemplates life on a journey to the surface. It is an exploration of the human soul through isolation. It's also a lot more lighthearted than it sounds, which is true. I really like Ascent. It has a really unique style, which is consistent throughout the entire comic so far. It is really funny, but you know, it actually gives you a lot to think about. I really like it. Personally, I think I see Ascent as a philosophical comic. That's you know, that's how it looks like to me. It really gives you things to think about. I know I have. I have thought about my own life through this comic, and you know, it has its funny moments. It's very cute moments too, with Dimple. So yeah, this is one of the most recent pages, I think, or not. No, I didn't choose the recent page because it was, the style is consistent. So yeah, that's Ascent. I really like this comic. It's very unique. Yeah. So now for the important parts. Are these comics updated? Are they active? And when are they updated? So The Breaker is complete, and let me tell you, it was finished on 2007. Yeah, it's old. And on 2010, a new The Breaker came out, which was called New Waves. I didn't like it at all. So I wouldn't recommend this one, but The Breaker, the first one that you see here, I really like it. And I'm not going to give any spoilers. I will not say the story is perfect or the ending is perfect, but it really gave me lots of feelings throughout the entire comic, so I would really recommend it. And it really exceeded my expectations, especially when it came to the protagonist. But I don't want to give you too high expectations, because then you might be disappointed. So just give it a try, okay? Because I read the reviews and there were many contradicting ones. So just give it a try if you want. And for Ascend, there have been 2 seasons, if I'm not mistaken, and there will be a third one, but not yet. From the new year, there will be a new season. We don't know when exactly. It is on a hiatus because the second season is done. So yeah, really good comics, both of them. I definitely recommend them. And that's all. There are links in the description of the video, like always. I hope you enjoyed the video, and subscribe, hit that bell button, and all that stuff. Bye bye.